Okay, this is Unit 3.7, Classical versus the Keynesian concept. So we're going to start over with the classical concept. If you notice that this is the typical ADAS graph, real GDP, Y at full employment, average price level. I'm going to say that we're going to call just the aggregate supply, not the long run. So according to classical theory, there's only one supply curve, and that supply curve is vertical. And let's say that this particular point is at Y at full employment, so output is at, our most efficient point of production, the natural rate of unemployment or full employment of output. And let's say that our demand curve is here, ED1. That's where our demand curve is. Wonderful. What happens if demand increases? What happens to the graph? Well, if demand increases, then, price level increases, right, to P2. What happened to output? Nothing. Classical theory. What if price level, I'm sorry, what if aggregate demand shifted to the left? Oh boy, we're in a recession, right? We're only going to be in a recession for a very short time because wages and prices, they adjust super quickly. So price level is going to drop very quickly and output's going to go back to equilibrium. So whether there's an inflationary movement in AD or a recessionary movement in AD, then there's going to be no change in price, but output's going to stay the same. If you combine now, look at the Keynesian supply curve. The Keynesian supply curve is not vertical. We're really talking about the horizontal aspect idea of prices and wages because prices and wages stick. So let's start ourselves at the first place. Let's put a demand curve here and say this is our full employment. This is at demand, aggregate demand at full employment, most efficient point of output. NRU is 4 to 5% unemployment and or full employment. Well, what happens if we decrease aggregate demand? Well, if we decrease aggregate demand, what changes? Well, not price level, but output's going to change. So output's going to be here. Why is that? Well, if aggregate demand shifts to the left, prices don't change, so the cost of wages doesn't change. So all that's really going to happen is we fire workers, and so output is going to decline, and they're never going to adjust. Well, in the short run, they're never going to adjust, and that's what Keynes is talking about. He's saying they stick. Now, both of these are not incorrect graphs. They're both theories. One's about classical theory, one's a Keynesian theory, but this one is used better in the long run to explain how things work. This is how things work better in the short run, more realistically. So the old way of thinking, as I said in the previous video, is that the market will fix itself, it will correct itself because prices adjust quickly. After the Great Depression, Keynes is a British economist, he hates capitalism, but he does point out why this wasn't, why the Great Depression happened. It happened because wages and prices stick. So when we combine them, it shows how they both kind of, in a sense, are both, they work together in the same graph. So this is an ADAS supply curve. It is a correct curve. This looks very similar to our short run aggregate supply, long run aggregate supply, and then AD curve, right? Well, this is not wrong, and this is not wrong. Okay, so you could see both theoretically in the class. If you draw it, it's not incorrect. But I want to explain the components here, the portions of the curve, the aggregate supply curve. Since it's a combination of both classical and Keynesian supply curves, the first part is called stage one, and we call it the Keynesian curve, sticky prices and wages. The second part here is upward sloping. Okay, so when price goes up, quantity increases. When price goes down, quantity decreases. So we call this stage two. Okay, this is stage one. Stage two is also called the intermediate. Okay, well, you do see some change in prices, but only to a point when quantity, when AD is shifting. And then you have the point where we cannot produce any longer. If this is the point of Y of full employment, then if we do increase aggregate demand, production will increase a little bit. Factories will be squeezing people in, working, producing a little bit more, but only to a point. Once you get past this point, you're going to hit the point where factories can no longer produce in the short run. The only way you can produce more is if you build more factories, and that shifts the whole supply curve to the right. So this third part here, stage three, is called your classical stage. Okay?
So looking at this, let's say I'll draw
stage one, stage two, stage three, aggregate supply. If aggregate demand is here, and this is my full employment, Y at full employment, then let's say there's a
increase in aggregate demand.
Well, if aggregate demand leaves this section, right, it goes up a little bit, and there's no problem, right? We get a little more output, as much as we can, price goes up just a little bit, demand increases. But what if we keep, aggregate demand keeps increasing? Well, then output, yeah, it's going to be a little bit greater than YF, but not much. It physically cannot. If aggregate demand keeps increasing, keeps increasing, keeps increasing, the only thing that's going to change is the price level. But what if we come back? If aggregate demand shifts to the left, well, price level stays the same because they stick. But output has now decreased significantly. What if it decreases again? Price level stays the same, output increases significantly. This is what happened in the Great Depression, Keynes explains. And it pulls us back further and further and further into a recession depression. And so, to fix the problem, there's two things. You can do a fiscal policy or a monetary policy. Both of them, we say there's a fiscal fiscal policy is expansionary or contractionary. Monetary policy is expansionary or contractionary. And they both try to manipulate aggregate demand. So let's see. Let's say we're in a recession. Which fiscal policy would you do? Expansionary fiscal policy you could do to get us out of the recession. Which monetary policy could you do? You could do expansionary monetary policy. We haven't gone over them yet, but at least you get the idea. If aggregate demand is too far to the right, then you do a contractionary fiscal policy or a contractionary monetary policy. All right, so here's a quick summary. Right, stage one, Keynesian. Prices and wages are sticky. Only output goes down as aggregate demand goes down. We typically focus on Keynes in the short run during recessions. His curve is horizontal, and there it looks like so. Stage two, the upward sloping part is the intermediate, the part between short run and long run. As price goes up, quantity goes up. As price goes down, quantity goes down. Okay, pretty, that's the one we would, a typical upward sloping supply curve. Stage three, classical, is your vertical aggregate supply. Prices and wages, they adjust quickly, so output stays the same as price changes. So as price goes up, quantity stays the same. As price goes down, quantity stays the same at your long run full employment. All right, that's the concept. I hope you understand it.